Father,
we come again this morning, Master, in the name of Jesus. Father, we come to you thanking you for this day. We thank you for another opportunity to make our way back to the house of prayer one more time. We thank thee, O God, for last night's rest, Master, for awakening us from the portion of our mind, Master. We realize, O God, that many rose this morning that didn't have it. And we thank you, O God. We thank you for our church family here this morning.
Amen.
We thank you for our pastor and his family this morning. Father, we thank you for this congregation, Master. We realize, O God, that we all come this morning with different needs, Master. And we ask, O God, that you just look down and have mercy upon us. Forgive us, O God, of all our many, many sins and our shortcomings, Master. And help us, O God, that we might do better tomorrow, Master.
Yeah.
Well, Lord, we ask for strength on this day, Master. We ask that you would just bless your preached word. We pray, oh God, that your word might have power, Father, that somebody might be delivered, that somebody might come forward today, Master.
Yeah.
And Father, we ask that your blessings upon those that might be sick among us, those that are in bereavement this morning, Master. We ask your blessings upon us, Master. Help us to and lead us and guide us in the direction that you have us to go, Master. Father, we ask you to bless all families here this morning, Master. Bless our children, Father. Help us, oh God, that we might be a light before them, Master. That they might see our lives and see Jesus in our lives and want to come to you this morning, Master. These and other blessings we ask in Jesus' name for his sake.
Trustees, members, and friends. Do we have any visitors today? If so, would you please stand? Any visitors? Well, thank you. We're so happy to have you today. Would you like to have a word, say something, your name, where you're from? Please remain standing. We're so happy to have you. And this morning, Morningstar is going to show you how we love our visitors. We love to have you. So, Jerome.
Well, I'm so tired of being a summer. from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Is there anybody in here that can agree with me to say he's worthy of all our praise? Amen. And giving honor to that awesome God that allowed us one more opportunity and one more breath to praise his holy name. Amen. So the deacon said, the choir that sung so beautifully this morning, all of my father's children here in the Morningstar family and on the web. We're so glad to be here. Usher, you may be seated. Amen. Turn with us to James chapter 1, verse 13 through 15. James chapter 1, verse 13 through 15. We'll be coming from the King James Version of God's Holy Writing. You have another translation, that's quite all right. We're going to wind up on the same road because it is the Word of God. All right, so yeah, you look for that. I remember this song when I was younger. I used to sing like this. Oh, how I love Jesus. 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 Chapter 1, starting at verse 13. If you haven't, say amen. Amen. Not say, wait a minute. Amen. I don't know what he said, but I don't believe that he said, wait a minute. Amen. It reads like this: let no man say, then, when he is tempted, that I am tempted of God. For God cannot be tempted with evil, neither tempteth he any man. But every man is tempted when he is drawn away of his own lust and enticed. Then when lust has conceived, it brings forth sin. And sin, when it is finished, brings forth death. May God have a blessing to the reading of his awesome word. I'd like to talk with you briefly with the aid of the Holy Spirit from this thought: the truth about temptation. The truth about temptation. How many in here have never been tempted? I'm going to say, if I see some hands go up, I need to talk to you. Because I believe everybody in here has been tempted one time or another in this life. Amen. I don't know about you. You can't even watch a burger commercial without him showing a half-nigger woman. Or vice versa. Amen. Amen. No matter what we go through, we can cut on the radio and there's suggestions of what someone wants to do to you. Amen. And cut on television, reality shows are going cuckoo crazy. Yeah. Just a public service announcement. If you're going outside and there's a dog out there that's chasing folk, don't run. Come on back inside. It's God trying to tell you to stay in. Right. Amen. But be careful, y'all. Amen. But no matter what life throws your way, it's something that is trying to entice you. James moves in this scripture here today, the chapter. James moves from dealing with the Christians going through trials in verses 2 through 12 to enduring temptation in our text here today. The word trial and temptation is the same word in the Greek language, but it has two different meanings. Now, trial is a hardship, a problem, a trouble that centrally comes in every person's life. Amen. And these are tests that are sent by God to help us get stronger. Now, temptation, however, are motives to do wrong. Yeah, they are enticements to do evil. And these are traps set by Satan to make us stumble. Yeah, a simple way to remember the difference is that trials are to test us while temptations are to trap us. Trials are meant to strengthen our faith, while temptations are meant to weaken our faith. Am I right about it? Yeah, we can rely on the fact that Satan has temptations waiting on every last one of us. If you don't believe me, you just keep on living. Amen. Temptation will come your way. Yeah. We as Christians are at war with Satan. Amen. Yeah, and one of his biggest weapons is the weapon of temptation. Amen. He laces the ground with landmines. So my brothers and sisters, Satan has filled our spiritual lives not with landmines, but with lust mines. Yeah, for James says in verse 14, but each one is tempted when he is carried away and enticed by his own lust. Yeah, if you can picture your life as an open field, as you walk through it, you are going to have to be very careful and avoid stepping on lust mines. Yeah, for if you do so, it'll explode into sin. Yeah, now, be careful, y'all, to note that temptation is not a possibility here in a Christian's life. It's a probability. Yeah, so James, notice that James says in verse 13 that let no man say when he is tempted that I am tempted of God. For God cannot be tempted with either, neither will he be tempted any man. Yeah, don't get the idea that once you get saved that you're through with Satan and Satan is through with you. Amen. When we are saved, you just enlisted for the duty of God's army. And he has sent you immediately to the front line, and Satan has you and I in his sights. Yes, yeah, I want you to know that it's never too young or too old to be enticed by temptation. Sometimes temptation will come your way and you don't even know it. Amen. Amen. Just the other day, somebody, my wife said, disrespected her. Amen. Come up to me, and she called me, I'm green. Because I wasn't even thinking about it. But later on, I got to see how she was acting. And I said, Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Amen. I can only handle that when I got over there. Ain't got no time for nobody else. Right. Amen. Amen. But no matter what you do in life, you can have the best intentions, and I guarantee you that temptation will come your way. The truth about temptation is that God does not tempt us. Instead, temptation comes when we are drawn away by our own fleshly desires and enticements. Yeah, we want to follow the world as the devil, he provides the enticement for us. Can I let you in on a little secret that Satan's not going to tempt you with something you don't like? Amen. He's going to tempt you with a list of things that he knows that you like. Amen. He ain't nothing but a certified waiter. Amen. He's got a tray with everything you like on it, and he's going to wave it in your face, but it's up to you to accept it or reject it. And it might look good for you right now, but I guarantee it's going to be bad for you later. Amen. Don't you dare grab what he's offering you. Amen. Young folks, I tell you, y'all got more temptation than a little bit. Amen. Just the other day, I know y'all went to prom. And some of these outfits that these sisters had on, Lord, have mercy, Jesus. Amen. Yeah, the enticement can trap you in many ways. Amen. And you got to be careful even today. I'm sort of now trying to shake hands and give you that one shoulder. Because I don't want you to think that Pastor McSwain is trying to feel on you. Amen. Like, amen. It's going around now. Amen. From Bill Cosby to Charlie Sheen. Amen. That folk are getting caught up with the Me Too movement. And I ain't trying to get into that category. Amen. So we have to be careful. Amen. And don't you get no ideas. Amen. Because there's only one woman in my life, and she over there. Amen. So I love you to death. Amen. But there's no way on God's green earth that anybody in here gonna send me to hell. Amen. Amen. Temptation. Oh, don't y'all better watch out over there. Amen. Y'all ain't exempt neither. Amen. Amen. Temptation. From without has no power unless there is a corresponding desire within. Yeah, temptation isn't sin, but playing with temptation invites sin. Yeah, there's nobody in here that's strong enough to handle what the devil has to offer. Amen. So get in to what God has to offer so that you can tell him like Jesus told him to get thee behind me. Amen. I don't know about you, but nobody in here is super saints. Amen. Even me, I have to tell you that I struggle with temptation. Just as you do. Amen. Overcoming it is hard and it's a constant battle. Amen. But whether we succeed or fail, God, he still loves you and I. Yeah, when I forget that amazing fact. Yeah, overcoming temptation is harder and often impossible. Yeah, but I'm thankful here this morning that God promises forgiveness and that his grace and power is available to us. Yeah, Jesus is able to for us to stand here today. He enables you and I to stand against the temptation that we face here today. For Jesus said that when we pray, we ought to ask God to lead us not into temptation. Yeah, Paul even clears it up by letting us know that he was struggling with it too. When he says, I want to do right. Yeah, but evil lies close at hand. Yeah, for I will delight in the law of God in my inner being. But I see in my members another law that's waging war. Yeah, against the law in my mind. Yeah, making me a captive of the law of sin. dwells in my memory. And if I can just break it down to you here this morning. You say, every time I try to do right, evil is always present. Yeah, if you don't believe me, he'll get in your ears. He'll get in what you're looking at. He'll get in your voice and in your tongue. Yeah, if you ain't careful, Satan will use you if you don't be careful. But I always remember that God is aware of our temptation. Yeah, I'm so glad that he's compassionate in the struggle that we have with sin. But Hebrews 2:17 and 18 is an amazing and wonderful statement in the Bible. That why Jesus has entered into every detail of this human life. Yeah, when we come before God as a high priest to get rid of yours and my sin. Yeah, he's already experienced what we're going through. He experienced all our pain, all our testing, all our heartaches, all our joy, all our struggles, no matter what we go through. Yeah, he's able to give help where help is needed. Yeah, and just to make sure that things are understood. Hebrews 4:15-16 says, for we do not have a high priest who is unable to be sympathetic with our weakness. Yeah, but one who is with us and respects the temptation that we go through. Yet, he did it without sinning. Yeah, let us then be confident in drawing near to the throne of grace. Yeah, we receive that mercy and find grace in the help in times of need. Is there anybody in this place that knows that you lean on the everlasting arms of Jesus? Is there anybody in this place that when Satan begins to tempt you, you lean upon God's everlasting word? Yeah, if we stay in the word, we won't stumble in darkness. If we stay in the word, yeah, he'll lead and guide us all the way. If we stay in the word. Stay in the word. Imagine me being free, trusting you.